Good morning! Welcome to the Cactus Atlas. Today's adventure brings us to Montezuma Castle in Camp Verde, Arizona. Living in Arizona is really neat because there are so many old dwellings from the native people that lived in this area hundreds, if not into the thousands of years ago. Montezuma's Castle is one of the best examples of such dwellings. If you're a fan of this type of adventure, subscribe to our channel and also make good use of that notification bell. It'll keep you in the loop as to when we upload new adventures, which we do all of the time. As you can see, visiting here is a piece of cake, basically. You've got nicely paved trails. I believe they said it was about a third of a mile long, wheelchair accessible. There were a couple spots that said no wheelchairs, but overall, you won't exert yourself too much if you visit here. It's a nice leisurely loop. You could probably get it done within the course of an hour. So if you're traveling doing day trips, this could be a great stop because it's not going to occupy your whole day. Right off the interstate, great place to think about visiting if you haven't. Montezuma Castle is neither a castle, nor does it have any affiliation with the Aztec people or the Aztec Emperor Montezuma. The myth originated in the 1800s when many pioneers mistakenly thought that the Aztecs built this structure. This dwelling was made by a people known as the Sinagua. Sinagua is Spanish, meaning seen without, agua, water, Sinagua. And there it stands right behind me on that cliff, Montezuma Castle. As mentioned before, referring to this as a castle might be a bit of a stretch. Regardless, it's still a very impressive structure. Boasting 5 floors and enough room to house 50 people, I'd say this is one heck of an old-time apartment complex. Every time I come here and see this apartment complex up in the cliff, hundreds of years old, pushing into the thousands, I imagine what would it have been like living here. Living up on a cliff doesn't seem half bad. Built into a natural alcove, this had natural cooling in the summers and nice insulation in the wintertime. Living high up on a cliff would also provide a nice level of security from would-be intruders, as well as occasional flooding from nearby Beaver Creek. One thing to keep in mind is that human beings lived here, just like you and me. They had to tend to their daily needs, experienced happiness, joy, sadness, pain. They were just living life. You had sentinels keeping a close eye on the land down below, nervous mothers keeping a close watch over their children, food preparation and storage, weaving, hunting and gathering, and just generally taking care of each other. Things seemed pretty good here until about 1425 AD, when things mysteriously came to an end. So why did they leave? Nobody really knows the reason why. Some theorize it could have been drought, resource depletion, or even conflict with newly arrived tribes in the area. The idea of conflict with other tribes is something that I've not really read too much about, but I did find an interesting article on the internet, so have to take it with a grain of salt, that when this was finally abandoned, I think around circa 1400, they found evidence of burning in some of the structures. There's also graves of people that had evidence of trauma etched into their bone and charring in their bone, which makes it seem like there was a violent conflict here that prompted people to leave the area. Sites like Montezuma Castle and other settlements from the time seem very fortress-like. For example, the Sears K ruin right outside of Phoenix is built on a hilltop in a very defensible position and is oftentimes referred to as a fortification. I'll put a link in the description down below if you want to check that out. The main thought here is that if these people felt compelled to build defensive structures and eventually abandon the area, it seems feasible to me that a good reason for that could be the overabundance of violent conflicts. We're actually heading over to a place known as Site A, where they found evidence of this sort. According to the article that I mentioned, this is the site where they had found evidence of burning and potential conflict. Not much of Site A remains today, as it was all burned down, and much of what you see here has been reconstructed.
And there's a little bit of evidence about what I'm talking about. Looks like through excavation they determined the pueblo had burned, causing it to fall away from the cliff.
Side A consisted of 5 floors and is thought to have been larger than the castle portion that remains today. For the time being, Montezuma Castle is not giving up all of its secrets, but it will continue to fascinate and astonish visitors for a long time to come.
So we decided to start a new tradition here on the Cactus Atlas, which is to get a National Parks passport book, where we actually get to stamp the date that we visited the location, as well as other regional stamps that we can have, so we can kind of keep track of our journeys here in this passport book. So let's do this for the very first time. So the first thing you need to do is find the region that you visited, and then we're going to do what's called a cancellation stamp, which is just the date that we visited here. So let's do our first one. Ready? August 7th of 2019. So you can see we did the cancellation stamp and we verified that is the correct location to put that. And if you want to be really official, we were trying to figure out what the regional stamp is. We thought it was actually one of these. You can actually see over here, you have one for Montezuma National Monument, but we did find out that it's actually these stickers that you'll affix to the book. And we're not gonna do that right here and now, but we just wanted to explain in case you were interested in doing a passport book. Well, that's gonna conclude our adventure here today at Montezuma Castle at Camp Verde, Arizona. We hope you enjoyed yourself. If you're new here, please consider subscribing to our channel and make use of that big like button. Let us know that you like our content. Also, if you want to keep on top of all of our adventures, hit the notification bell. That way you're notified whenever we release new material, which is all the time. Well, until next time, take it easy and we'll see you on a new adventure right around the corner.